that feeling that the more you interact with technology, the more searching you do online, the more you're being watched?
Yeah, it's kind of creepy, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Senator Al Franken certainly does, and now he's trying to make so-called stalking apps illegal. Steve Patterson is here with details on that. Steve?
You know what, too, and to the creepy end, if I can tell you guys this. In the newsroom, I was talking about this, and I said, I kind of like it. I shop for ties online. I kind of like it whenever I go to another website, and it's like, maybe you like this tie. I thought that was a little bit cool. Resoundingly no.
I am clearly
the minority there. It is creepy.
I think I don't like it at all.
Okay.
Because I'm like,
I'm going to change my opinion.
How does my Hotmail account know that what I was searching for online at the, you know, at Nordstrom or at Macy's or at Penny's or wherever? I don't like that.
All right.
That's weird.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna shift over to weird now. The crowd has won me over, and a lot of us have probably experienced one level of being watched online, but I got to tell you, Senator Al Franken, what he is talking about really goes to something way beyond that. He believes that there's a loophole that exists in the Electronic Communications Privacy Act. The companies that have GPS access to your devices are free to give it or to sell it to just about anybody. Now, many of us use apps like Google Maps who know where we are, but they ask us for our permission first. But it's the apps and software that collect that information without asking that Senator Franken is trying to crack down on, and he told us why it's so important.
My bill basically says that people have a right to privacy, and that includes their location information. This is very private information. It's where you live, where you work, where you take your kids to school, if you go to the doctor, how often you go to the doctor, where you go to the doctor.
So this deals, of course, with apps that have GPS activity and can just track you without really telling you, but there are also legitimate stalking apps and software which will just freak you out. Take a look at this. This is from FlexiSpy. And it just blatantly says it. Here's how you can stalk people. Here's how you can look in. And actually, on their website down in the corner, there's a passcode cracker app that you can get to. So he wants to make sure that these things are illegal, that
okay,
you just can't do
this
them.
This just kind of jumped out at me now as from the parents' perspective. And, you know, the kids are getting to the age where they're, I mean, they're downloading stuff all the time.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, as a parent, I want to be able to stalk my kids and find out what they're doing. So, you know, like, there's got to be some kind of give and take there when we talk about legislating all this.
Yes, and he specifically notes that in this bill, that parents would still be allowed to do that, and that in the case of an emergency, that emergencies, they, you'd be able to be tracked by different emergency departments should they need to in a dire sort of a situation. So there would be the appropriate loopholes. He thinks that there are loopholes right now, but they're helping the wrong people.
Hmm.
Better go back and get some tie shopping done.
Oh, look, it just alerted me. I would like that tie.
Hey, Steve. Yep.